Political correctness has gone too far, and banning people from referring to black coffee does little to promote equality. That is the view of the new president of the National Black Police Association. Inspector Andrew George from the PSNI joins us on the line now. Andrew, thank you indeed for talking to us. You think we've got the emphasis wrong. Is that a fair description of your argument?
Yeah, no, I would agree. As I said, political correctness itself hasn't has created a lot of opportunities for ethnic minority communities, but I think in some instances it maybe has gone too far. And again, that allows those that don't want to see equality come through to kind of use it against that kind of particular movement or that particular push for equality.
Now, look, as a police officer, you're not saying, and you've already said it, you're not saying, look, that political correctness is all bad. And look, there has been, I'm sure, a lot of positives in your job. And I know the Black Lives Matter protest around the world is something you also do feel strongly about.
No, definitely. I mean, like, for me, the Black Lives Matter protest, the death of George Floyd, was almost that visual representation of what ethnic minorities have had to deal with their whole life. You know, that being held down by the system, and those words from George Floyd around "I can't breathe." You know, a lot of my colleagues in the Black Police Association could really resonate with those, because when they suffer discrimination, that's how they feel, that they can't breathe at times because they're isolated in the workplace and they don't have the same opportunities as their kind of counterparts.
So where does the problem arise in your view?
For me, a lot of it is it's about consultation. A lot of what we do in policing now is about co-design. We look at the problem from a community perspective, or we look at it from the person's perspective that we need to fix a problem with. And I think with political correctness, it probably didn't involve those that it most impacted. I think it was done by people with the best of intentions, but because they didn't understand the root causes and the complexity of a lot of these issues, and they didn't consult with ethnic minorities in general, I think that's where we've probably lost a lot of ground on that.
I suppose the argument, the counter argument, would be that by getting people to second guess is the wrong word, but to think about what they're doing, think about what they're saying, well, that leads to less prejudice and less racism.
I think it does, you know, but at the same time, if I'm sitting with somebody and they mention a black coffee, for me, the coffee's black, you know what I mean?
You're not going to take offence at that, clearly.
It doesn't mean anything about racism, and I know everybody's threshold's different, but for me, if you're getting that offended about a coffee that is actually black, or a whiteboard or blackboard, and it's just describing the colour of the blackboard, that has nothing to do with the racism and the discrimination that ethnic minorities face all the time. So for me, it's taken away from the real issues, and it's allowing those that don't want to see equality come through to kind of take away the message, and that's where the snowflake generation, etc., has come through. You know, political correctness needs to be run in conjunction with all of these other systems and processes if we really want to make meaningful changes and kind of make a better, fair and equitable society for all.